Hello to everyone, in this video I'll share my first impressions from the new Tenere 700. Of course, I'll try to be as objective as possible without any different bias. I'll share my honest opinion about it. So if you have nothing to do, you can grab your favorite drink and stay with me. Welcome back. If you don't know me, my name is Pavlin and I'm a motorcycle traveler. On this channel, if you upload anything related to long motorcycle trips, so you might consider subscribing. Maybe you know, maybe you don't, but I'm a long-term user of a Yamaha Tenere XT660Z. Actually, I've got some kind of a record because my old Tenere got 193,000 kilometers without any problems. And this, of course, put me in the position to be an owner of the new Tenere. This was the most logical choice for me. And as I promised earlier, in this video now, I'm going to share my first impressions from the model. The pros, the cons, everything that I have noticed so far. If you followed my channel for a while, you already know that I'm always honest with my video reviews. So everything that I'm going to tell you today, the opinion that I'm going to share, will be my honest opinion. Of course, this will be my point of view. It doesn't mean that you have to be the same, but as I promised, it is going to be honest. Alright, first things first. The price of the motorcycle is maybe the most competitive price at the market today. It is just around 10,000 euros, which makes it the most affordable option on the market. Yes, it hasn't got the extras or the features that most of the expensive models got. The only extra that it has, it's the ABS, which is switchable with one single button. But to be honest, this is everything I need. I'm not saying that you have to be the same. I'm saying what I need. Anyway, in terms of build quality, functionality and the price, I think this everything is average on this model. I love this engine. It provides the power that I need. It provides the petrol consumption that I need. And when I'm talking about petrol consumption, let me share my experience in the last 700 kilometers. Unfortunately, in the last month I was very, very busy with a personal project and I haven't got much time to ride it, but I still got 700 kilometers. And petrol consumption in this 700 kilometers always been under 4 liters. Of course, keep in mind that now the motorcycle is in a break-in mode, which just means that I don't twist that hard, but I don't expect the petrol consumption to be more than 4.5, maximum 5 liters per 100 kilometers, which is, I will say, perfect for my type of trips and my type of travelings. The second point that I would like to discuss is the weight. It's weighed around 204 kilograms, which makes it again some of the lighter in the category. Even that, I understand that 200 kilograms are not that light. If you are coming from the dirt bikes, 200 kilograms sounds like a lot. But if you are coming from adventure riding, let's say traveling with adventure motorcycle, you know that 200 kilograms are manageable. For this type of roads, the road I'm riding now, or something that similar that you might face on your trips, 200 kilograms, as I said, are manageable. All of these 220, 230 are still fine, but of course you might have many difficulties if you need to pick up the bike a number of times. The next point that I would like to discuss is the suspension. Do I need to upgrade it now? Well, I'm gonna disappoint you and will tell you that I don't have such a plans. This suspension is more than enough for my type of trips, for similar terrains like what I'm experienced now, because I don't think that this motorcycle is designed for a heavy off-road use. It is designed to be able to cross a sections like this when you need it. So for that purpose, I think that this suspension is more than enough. Now I've got this rocky terrain and I have to tell you that this 43 mm stock suspension absorb it really, really well. It's given me enough confidence to ride it here, even though the bike is brand new and I haven't got much experience with it, because of the weight and because of the suspension. Riding on the forest tracks like this, as I said guys, it is just a pleasure. This grass is wet and it's a bit slippery. I'll try not to fall. Okay, here it's a bit better. Maybe not the proper day, because now the temperature is how many degrees? Let me check. 12 degrees, and you can see the water on the top of the grass. This makes the surface really slippery, and as I said, with these tires, it's maybe not the right choice. But it is what it is. Another option that I like so much is the possibility to turn off the ABS with a single switch. Just hold it for a few seconds and the ABS is off, because on the terrains like this, if you like to stop with the ABS, it will be almost impossible, especially when you go downhill. I've got an experience like this, let's say 2 months ago, with parts of Tenere on a very, very steep downhill. I forgot to turn off the ABS, and man, it was disaster going downhill, pressing the brakes and feel nothing, and the motorcycle does not stop at all. Oh, it was a scary moment, and considering the fact that it was not my motorcycle, oh man, luckily I managed to go through. I don't know how, but I just got it, probably a luck or something like that. But never again. So the ABS could be a great feature, especially on the road, on the asphalt road, but on the dirt roads it's completely pointless. Even so, that this Tenere, the ABS of this Tenere, it's not that sensible, and you can ride it on some dirt roads even with the ABS turned on, but on the steep hills, no, absolutely not. Let me twist a little bit more here on the dry surface. As I said, this suspension is more than enough for me and my type of trips. For single track, big rocks, nah, you'll need something more serious. But for this type of terrains, I think it's fine. Try one more serious jump here. This one here, it's not serious jump, but just a little bit more. Yeah, it's all right. I also like to test the tail, because everybody said that it's going to hit the tire, which I cannot believe, but we will see. Okay, I think that is enough from the dirt roads. One thing is clear, this is not a dirt bike. Just because someone labeled it adventure bike, and because Paul Tarres, international trial racer and champion, is capable to do miracles with this motorcycle, does not mean that you will be able to do it. The brakes, of course, are more than enough for someone like me. If you're coming from sport bikes with very powerful brakes, you might find this weak, but for me it is just fine. Because of its size and its weight, it is very easy to do maneuvers on the roads like this. See, I can U-turn on this. How many meters is this? 3 or 4, maybe 4 meters. Acceleration more than enough. Keep in mind that now at the moment I do not exceed 5 1000 RPMs because of the braking procedure. But I have ridden this bike before and I know what it is, so I am absolutely happy with the power. It is so good for maneuvers. It's going so well into the corners and you just twist the throttle and it's going exactly where you need it. I really like this. And the gears are so precise, they just give you enough boost to go to the next and next and next, and it sounds like very powerful engine, even that it is not. On the bumper roads like this, when you stand on the pegs, you just go over it and the suspension works absolutely fine. As I said guys, the three main points in any motorcycle are brakes, engine and suspension, and you shouldn't make any compromises with. So the brakes of this motorcycle for me are absolutely perfect for adventure type of trips. For racing they will be weak, but for adventure type of trips they will be fine. Suspension, the same story, perfect for traveling, for adventure type of travelings. Racing or hard terrains, no, it will be weak. And engine, more than enough for adventure type of traveling, maybe not enough for racing, but it is what it is. Standing position, for me, I am 185, it is, I'll say, perfect. When I sit on it, I would like to have maybe 1 cm or 2 cm bar risers to give me a little bit more height and a little bit more backwards. So because the angle of the holders is like 45 degrees, if I have 2 cm, I'll have at the same time the height and the backwards a little bit, and this will give me just perfect sitting position, and I believe that it will be all right even when I stand. But as I said, on the roads like this, bumpy roads, when you stand, it's just perfect. So many people complain from the seat and say that the seat is awful. I perfectly understand. I've got more than enough kilometers sitting on the seats like this. I know what it is, but the cure is that you don't really need to spend hundreds of dollars to upgrade your seat. What I have pain, I just stand for a while, 5-10 minutes, and then sit again and stand and sit, and this is much easier option than to spend hundreds of dollars and find out that on some stage it will be the same story. Because even if you sit comfortably on your couch at home, after a few hours you will feel a pain. The visibility of the dashboard, you can see it by yourself. It doesn't matter where I stand, on the sun or on the shadow, I can see everything very, very well. I don't need complicated dashboard. Of course, it's a matter of personal choice, what exactly you need, how many features, but this is just fine. One control button here to change the settings down there, and that's it. As I said, this is more than enough for me, but for some geeks who would like to play with the tablets and play with the modes, this will be just too simple to go. But as usual, I'm focused on more like riding than the real touching the bike. I just want to experience the ride, the trips, the scenes, the people, than the real bike. As I said many times, the bike is just a tool. Maybe it is the best tool that you ever got, but it doesn't change the fact that it is still a tool. It handles the corners so well. Yeah, for this type of roads, between the villages, curvy roads, twisty roads, fantastic. Let me now find a proper place to stop and summarize everything for you guys. Okay, here will be just fine.
Let me now tell you for the third time in this video, the most important parts of any motorcycle are the engine, the suspension and the brakes. So this model tick all the boxes for me. The engine is more than enough for me. I'm telling you, for me. Not for one who like to race, not for one who like to be in front of everyone and like to ride with 160 km on the highways or even more. Suspension, more than enough for me. not enough. If you like to ride only off-road, if you race, if you go on single tracks, yes, you need to upgrade it. Brakes, more than enough for someone like me who is not riding fast and it focused more on the riding than in the bikes itself. When these big three are already covered, then I will ask for reliability. Fortunately enough, for this model, not exactly for this model, but for this engine, we already got enough history. Even this model is already 2 years old without any serious problems. Only when these already 4 points are covered, then I can think about different things like design. And by the way, I really like the design. It is very, very similar to my old Tenere. I really like the design, still like the design of the old Tenere. And this is as well, very beautiful design, especially now after I chopped the tail. That I know that not many people like this, but it's just perfect to me. I like the design of the windscreen, front fender, everything. So for those who are interested, I do not plan any changes. The suspension is going to be the same. I do not plan any high fender. This is just fantastic for me. I don't want to change it. I might lift it here with a centimeter, but that's it. I do not plan to change the shock. I do not plan to change the muffler as well. The stock is just fine. Sounds beautifully to me. I'm not going to spend 1,000 euros just because of the better sound of Akrapovic, or maybe 3, 4, 5 horsepower. As I said, this is more than enough. I'm not going to change the seat for now. Maybe in the future, if I've got a good deal from Rally Seat, I might think about it, but this is just fine to me now. I have enough length to step properly on the ground. So honestly, guys, in the stock condition, the bike is just fine. Also, very important, I do not plan to change the petrol tank. I know that Acerbis got this 22 liters. I don't really like how it looks like. It's open up big gaps here, completely change the design. And the most important that I don't want to change it is because I don't want to go and mess with a fuel pump, even that many people suggest that it's very simple procedure. I don't really believe in this. Also, in my opinion, the stock components are always better. So for now, we don't have long-term opinions about this tank Acerbis. We'll see how it's going to be when the weather is really hot, how it's going to deform, or who knows. I prefer to have the stock parts because they're insured reliability of the motorcycle. And these 16 liters are more than enough. As I told you guys, in the last few days when I was riding around, I was having at least 300-320-30 kilometers before the reserve lamp start lighting, and when it's got, I've got at least more 100 kilometers. So 400 kilometers or at least 350 kilometers range is more than enough for me, honestly. So in the near future, if I need to go to the places like Magadan, I know one section there for sure that it's 450 kilometers without any petrol, I will just take a petrol can, mount it here, 5 liters, go through this section and then throw it away. So in my opinion, this is a very good motorcycle for someone like me who is not really focused on the bikes, more focused on the trips, if you understand what I mean. I would like to travel. With what? It doesn't really matter. Yes, I bought this motorcycle now because my old model is already too old and sooner or later it's going to break. It's not because with this I'm gonna have a better trips. No, with this I'm gonna have, I guess, a better or longer reliability. Will continue travel free. This is what I need, not exactly the power, the performance, or the view of the bike. Yeah, this is all nice if you have it, but not something, or not the main reason why I changed the motorcycle. I like the design of the dashboard. As I said, now you can see it, even that I am against the light, you can see everything. Simple. I am a simple man, I like simple things. So that's everything from me for today, guys. I hope that this at least gave you some information what I think about the model. Of course, I plan a lot of reviews, long-term reviews, but let's first break in the model properly. Then I'm gonna ride it in hopefully in many trips, and of course I will share everything for you guys. Don't forget to subscribe, because the next week I'm gonna have another video with the new changes that I plan, like central stand, some parts and stuff like that. So always ride safe and see you next time. Ciao.